First year, I had 11 fights. I won a schoolboy title. I had 11 fights with 10 knockouts. I knocked everyone out in the first year of the schoolboys. And I went on the next year and then won a schoolboy title again. And I won an NLAC title. Then another schoolboy title. Junior ABAs. Won another junior ABA and then won a senior ABAs.
Considered a serious medal prospect for the Athens Olympics, the Dagenham featherweight instead opted to punch for pay and made his debut here against the experienced Stevie Quinn.
Oh, wonderful! Left hook!
Shrugging off the heavy weight of expectation to win in the very first round.
And again! It's the perfect professional stop.
A lot of pressure, but he's got very broad shoulders, this kid. He's running a million, this kid. He's confident. He's got good support from family behind him. He absolutely lives boxing. I mean, he studies videos of all different types of fighters, and he'll come in the gym each day and he'll go, I watched this fighter last night, he does this and he does that. And he carries it into his sparring. It's such a great guy, it's unbelievable.
There are no guarantees he'll make it to the top, but Mitchell certainly doesn't lack the talent or self-belief.
I want to be a world champion. I want to hold 3 world titles in one weight. That's what I want to do, about 23, 24 years old.
So it's plenty of ambition. It's Kevin Mitchell against Shabal Adani. Let's rejoin Ian and Jim.
Former ABA champion Kevin Mitchell from Dagenham, who's already getting the big treatment. He's been featured in magazines. And Frank Warren says he's his biggest signing in the London area since Nigel Benn. He says if he listens, does things the right way, he can become a multi-millionaire. Well, it's big talk. He won his first fight against Stevie Quinn of Northern Ireland in one round and looked very good doing it. Mitchell, only 18, in the blue trunks here, in with Shabal Adani. In only his third pro fight, he comes from the Hungarian capital of Budapest. He's won both the previous two. Mitchell, with massive support, at an arena from which he could walk home. He's from Dagenham, he's in Dagenham tonight.
This career, who you really feel is going to be something special and go all the way, and that's how everybody feels about young Mitchell here. Long, hard road ahead of him, but I think he is a special talent.
Feels like he's sold out the arena on his own tonight, judging by the kind of reception he got. A lovely right hand he hit there. But the road is a long and arduous one, with many a hurdle. Typical European type, this Ladagne, chin in the air, and he's very upright.
Mitchell's getting close already. They'll have to see anything Ladagne has to keep him off.
Mitchell admits he was a bit of a tear away this school days, but says boxing's really settled him down. Very anxious to please. There's a bit of pressure on a youngster like this who gets talked about.
I get the feeling he'll thrive on it when you see the look on his face. Oh, beautiful punch there.
Lovely shot. Left the gap. Ladagne. Mitchell takes advantage. Got up with the count at about 3 or 4. But Mitchell has his man down in round one. And he looks like a youngster with tremendous self-belief. He just could be a hot one, this Kevin Mitchell. Oh, left hook. Ladagne didn't see it coming, didn't go down, but it stopped in round one. His eyes, I think, were swimming. That was enough for Ian John Lewis, who calls it off. And that's 2 fights, 2 first round wins for Kevin Mitchell from Dagenham, and this time on home ground.
His hands dropped just with the shock of that punch. He was gone. Another couple of punches could have done serious damage. So perfect timing from referee Lewis to just step in there. But again, excellent performance from young Kevin Mitchell.
There's Mark. She still does the cooking for him. She has to watch the weight of it. He's only 9'2" tonight for a non-title fight. A couple of pounds over the featherweight limit. but this is a genuinely exciting prospect.
Yeah, you can feel the buzz as he came into the ring, you know, the whole crowd behind him already. He's going to sell some tickets. I think he's going to really have an exciting career. We're looking forward to it. Signs, it could be a little bit flash here and there, but that's all part of his makeup. The first knock was out, he was stunned, Ladanyi, not seriously hurt, but the punch seemed to catch him around about the ear. So he took his balance away down his line. But the finishing punch was a corker. It was a quality shot, left hook, bang on the chin. You can see the hands just dropped, doesn't quite know where he is. The referee showed excellent timing there just to step in.
Really good piece of refereeing by Ian John Lewis there, because Ladanyi would have been in danger. He was completely disorientated. Only the ropes were keeping him up anyway. And, yep, the ref did his job to perfection in saving Ladanyi from any more.
And even Mitchell himself, I think he realised the way he stepped back there, the job was over. He didn't lunge in to finish the job. I think he knew himself. He must have felt the power of that shot to his elbow. The job was done.
I think he just might be a star. Kevin Mitchell is the name. You'd be best to remember it.
It's still early days, but so far you're more than living up to the hype.
Yeah, it was a good night. I'm living up to your app. Listen, Johnny, he's telling me to dip with the right hand, dip the body, and then throw the right hand over the top, and it worked out really. So good night, good opponent, and early really. I've done it really early.
It was the perfect right hand you caught him with to start the finish.
It was a good right hand, not perfect. It was good. But, I'll improve with my shots more.
And your finishing ability was very good as well.
Yeah, I caught him with a flush of punches towards the end. I rocked him once and I rocked him twice. I'd have hit him. I went flush on punches. If I'd have hit him properly, then I think he'd been on the floor a bit quicker, really.
A lot of support here in Dagenham. You seem to be enjoying yourself.
No, I love it. I love everyone. I've had it since I was a young kid, so I've just lived up to it. Everyone's out there now, look, dad and that. So everyone's, yeah, they love it.
Just a word with your promoter, Frank Warren. Frank, how good is he?
Well, early days yet. I mean, he's done everything that's been asked him up to as yet, but it's a long way to go. He's only 18, and we're going to bring him along slowly, let him learn his trade, his profession, and then when the time's right, we'll let him off the lead.
He's an exciting talent, isn't he?
He's very exciting, and you know, he's only going to get better. He's not going to get worse, that's for sure. So I'm really enjoying working with young Kevin. I think at the end of the day, you know, when you're working with guys, you can see they've got something a little bit special, a little spark there. For what we see, actually translates and transforms into him being the fighter we think he's going to be. Then it's going to be great for British boxing, great for him, and I'll certainly enjoy it as well.
This is what fight school's all about.
It is all about bringing these youngsters through, giving experience, and, you know, and for the fans at home, actually getting the opportunity to see them in their younger days, in their early careers, developing. You say, well, I see that kid have his first fight or his second fight, and he's one to watch.